Thank you, Mr. Nixon. That completes the opening statements, and now the candidates will answer questions or comment upon one another's answers to questions put by correspondents of the networks. The correspondents.
I'm Sander Van Oker, NBC News.
I'm Charles Warren, Mutual News.
I'm Stuart Novin, CBS News.
Bob Fleming, ABC News.
The first question to Senator Kennedy from Mr. Fleming.
Senator, the Vice President in his campaign has said that you are naive and at times immature. He has raised the question of leadership. On this issue, why do you think people should vote for you rather than the Vice President?
Well, the Vice President and I came to the Congress together in 1946. We both served in the Labor Committee. I've been there now for 14 years, the same period of time that he has. So that our experience in government is comparable. Secondly, I think the question is, what are the programs that we advocate? What is the party record that we lead? I come out of the Democratic Party, which in this century has produced Woodrow Wilson and Franklin Roosevelt and Harry Truman, and which supported and sustained these programs which I've discussed tonight. Mr. Nixon comes out of the Republican Party. He was nominated by it. And it is a fact that through most of these last 25 years, the Republican leadership has opposed federal aid for education, medical care for the aged, development of the Tennessee Valley, development of our natural resources. I think Mr. Nixon is an effective leader of his party. I hope he would grant me the same. The question before us is, which point of view and which party do we want to lead the United States?
Mr. Nixon, would you like to comment on that statement?
I have no comment.
The next question to Vice President Nixon from Mr. Van Oker.
Mr. Vice President, since the question of executive leadership is a very important campaign issue, I'd like to follow Mr. Novin's question. Now, Republican campaign slogans, you'll see them on signs around the country as we did last week, say, it's experience that counts. That's over a picture of yourself, sir. Implying that you've had more governmental executive decision-making experience than your opponent. Now, in his news conference on August 24th, President Eisenhower was asked to give one example of a major idea of yours that he adopted. His reply was, and I'm quoting, "If you give me a week, I might think of one. I don't remember." Now, that was a month ago, sir, and the president hasn't brought it up since. And I'm wondering, sir, if you can clarify which version is correct, the one put out by Republican campaign leaders or the one put out by President Eisenhower?
Well, I would suggest, Mr. Van Oker, that if you know the president, that was probably a facetious remark. I would also suggest that insofar as his statement is concerned, that I think it would be improper for the President of the United States to disclose the instances in which members of his official family had made recommendations, as I have made them through the years, to him, which he has accepted or rejected. The President has always maintained, and very properly so, that he is entitled to get what advice he wants from his cabinet and from his other advisors without disclosing that to anybody, including, as a matter of fact, the Congress. Now, I can only say this. Through the years, I have sat in the National Security Council. I have been in the cabinet. I have met with the legislative leaders. I have met with the president when he made the great decisions with regard to Lebanon, Kimoi Matsu, other matters. The president has asked for my advice. I have given it. Sometimes my advice has been taken. Sometimes it is not. I do not say that I have made the decisions. And I would say that no president should ever allow anybody else to make the major decisions. The president only makes the decisions. All that his advisors do is to give counsel when he asks for it. As far as what experience counts and whether that is experience that counts, that isn't for me to say.